Hello and welcome to Mountain Vista Basketball. I'm Jake Riffle and I'm joined here with Jack Schauer. This is the final game of the regular season and the Mountain Vista Golden Eagles are 14-8 and they're squaring off against the 16-6 Highlands Ranch Falcons. Vista is competing at a higher seed, Vista is competing for a higher seed in the playoff tournament with a win here, and Ranch is looking to solidify their spot. The Falcons are a very strong team, but sometimes they struggle to score consistently. Jack, what do you think the keys are to this game for both of these teams here?
Well, for Vista especially, I think they need to eliminate the turnovers. They need to make good passing choices. They like to force the ball down the court a little too much, especially after they get turnovers, and that's what really leads to a lot of scoring runs for the other teams. I think they really need to get the ball to Connor Stud, Garrett Sweeney, get it to your shooters, your hot hands, let them create the plays for you. And then they need to get the bench involved with Albertson and Luke Moink and Eric Kimmel. They've been playing really well, and they sometimes don't like to play them too much in the first half, so then you rely too much on them in the second. And really, they need to shut down Sullivan. Sullivan's Ranch's best player, and I think if they can shut him down, they can shut down Ranch's whole entire game.
I agree, and something that Vista traditionally struggles with is playing too hard in the first half and then not leaving any gas in the tank for the second half, so maybe they can keep that in check and just kind of adjust to that. And what do you think are the keys for Ranch tonight?
Well, Ranch, I think they need to be quick in transition, especially after if they get a turnover or anything like that, because after a turnover, Vista likes to kind of stop and try and look around for everything. I think if Ranch is quick when they're getting the ball, they can be able to, you know, cause a lot of problems here for Vista. I think they need to get players other than Sullivan involved. They need to get, I think, Messman involved. He's been a fairly consistent player for them this year. But really, I think if they rely too much on Sullivan, this game's going to go downhill for them. And lastly, if they take a early lead, I think Vista's going to tire out, and they're not going to be able to play well in the second half. And that's really where I think Ranch can beat them, is in the second half of this game.
Right, and it looks like we're getting ready to tip here. I like what you had to say about the fast breaks. I agree with that. I think if Ranch takes their time on those, they're going to find that they're not as profitable as they would be just trying to hustle down the court with one or two guys.
Right, and I think another thing that is interesting to see here is a big defensive player for Vista this year has been Sheldon Hafner. Well, in the last game, he dislocated his shoulder, so it's going to be interesting, I think, to see how he plays. With a hurt shoulder, you know, obviously you don't recover 100% in a week's matter. And he did play in the county game, and he did have a fairly solid game. But I think it'll just be interesting to see here how much the Woods decide to use him, especially with how he's been feeling recently.
Right. Him and Connor Stye both aren't really at 100%. I believe they'll both play. I think their utilization, like you were saying, will come down to the score of this game and the tempo. If it's a really defensive battle, I bet we'll see Sheldon a lot more than normal. And if it's not, then I bet they'll be resting him, trying to get him good for their first round bye, and then after that.
Right. All right. We're about to get ready here for the national anthem, so we will turn you over to that.
society. And with that, we're going to start introducing players from both sides of the team. It appears that we'll be starting with Mountain Vista, but it could be Ranch. No, excuse me. It's going to be Ranch first. Number one, Courage. Number 11, Hammond. Austin Johnson is number 24.
And number 25, Brendan Sullivan.
Number 25, their best player, probably, not really even arguably, Brendan Sullivan.
Yeah, I think throughout, he leads them in all stats, so I mean, it'll be interesting to see how he plays tonight.
Right. And now we got Mountain Vista for their last time at home, at least, playing against a local rival. And yeah, here are a lot of the seniors, yeah.
I mean, in the last couple of years, really, Ranch has not been too much of a rival for Vista just because of the conference realignment in football, and then them just not being super competitive in the last couple of years in basketball and lacrosse and baseball. So, I mean, really, the rivalry kind of died out, but I think it still is a rivalry game for both of these teams, so it'll be important to this game's outcome, I think, for the next couple of years.
Right. Now, I have been following this team since 4 years ago when we had, like, Brady Subart, Isaac Essien, all of those guys, and I remember going, I think the first basketball game I went to as a high schooler was Mountain Vista versus Highlands Ranch at that stadium. Well, I guess their high school, and it was a great game because I believe Mountain Vista came out on top, but it was extremely competitive, and I enjoyed that game a lot. So I always enjoy the Mountain Vista versus Ranch game.
Right, and hopefully tonight the boys, for Vista at least, I mean, going to be a home crowd fan a little bit here. I mean, hopefully in their last game of the regular season, you know, you see them come out and they'll play well, hopefully, I think, for their last time in the regular season.
Right. I'd like to see that too, but I'd like to see a competitive game, good officiating.
It's always much more entertaining, I think, if it's a competitive game.
Right.
I think it'll make it a little more memorable if it's competitive.
Absolutely. And now we're getting set to tip off. So taking the tip, we got Connor Stibe facing off against number 25, Sullivan. So it's their two stud players facing off against each other.
Interesting thing I didn't really know, I guess. But Stibe is the second highest averaging points per game player in Mountain Vista basketball history.
Really?
Yes.
Who was before him?
Isaac Essien is the leading.
That makes a lot of sense. All right, Stibe has the ball. He takes a three shot and just a little bit too much. And now number one, Courage, is dribbling down the court. He passes to 25, Sullivan. Sullivan takes a shot, no good. Returned by Garrett Sweeney, and Garrett Sweeney will get a play going down there.
Yeah, and Stibe had a good shot there. I think he just put a little bit too much on it.
Right. And Ben Willis with an attempted three. Now he'll give it out to Garrett Sweeney, and he'll take a shot, and he'll make it, putting the first 2 points on the board. Excuse me.
Yes. And Vista's, I think, really trying to incorporate the three ball early here. The first two shots were threes.
Right. And now we got Sullivan back with the ball, and he'll kick it out and back at the top with Courage. Courage over to number 11, Hammond, and Hammond down to 25, Sullivan. Sullivan with the ball. They're trying to really create a lot of spacing. Do you think they're struggling offensively right now, or do you think it's just a strategy?
I think they're just passing the ball around a lot, trying to get an opening here for their shooters.
Right. Makes sense. And they're still on the outer perimeter. There isn't a shot clock in high school, so they could do this forever. But Courage takes a shot, did not make it, and Aaron Albertson gets the rebound. And now he'll pass it over to Connor Stibe, who thinks about the three, but he'll pass it underneath to Sheldon Hafner, and Hafner will try to drive inside, and a rough turnover there for him. And they'll give it over to, I believe, number 23, Hurdle.
Yeah, Sheldon didn't really have too much of an opening there against Sullivan. He tried to create something, and it just kind of ended up backfiring on him.
Right, and he had a bit of a mismatch there, too. I think Ranch plays, it looks like, a zone defense, and so he was going up against the big guy. And here's Sullivan back over to Hurdle. And then Courage will drive inside.
won't come up with anything, though. Brendan Sullivan will try the same thing. He'll kick it back to Courage, and Courage will take a shot. And still no points for Ranch there. Now Garrett Sweeney has the rebound, and he's dribbling it down the court to Ben Willis. Ben Willis will try and take a shot. He'll get fouled. It'll be interesting to see if they say shooting two here, and it looks like they will.
You know, it wasn't really a good foul there by Johnson. He really didn't have to take that foul. I think if he goes a little more under the basket there, he has a good chance of trying to block that shot or make a good defensive positioning. But instead, he just went right through Willis.
Right, and Willis didn't really have the best angle on that shot, like you were saying, so Willis kind of lucked out there. And he makes his first one. And he'll make his... He'll miss it, sorry. And Sullivan with the rebound, and he's dribbling down, trying to see what he can get going. He'll drive inside and try to pass it out, but is not fruitful.
Good defense there by Aaron Albertson. Was playing really tight to Sullivan. Didn't let him get inside.
Absolutely. And Aaron Albertson's a tall guy, too. He is, let's see, where's his stats? He's got 4.1 points per game, 2.8 rebounds per game. He's 6'2", I believe. So he's got to have those long arms. So he's a good assist player there.
Sweeney with a deep three ball there.
Ooh, not quite. And Ranch will take the ball, give it an open shot, and Hammond will make a three-point shot there. It's a tie game now between Mountain Vista and Highlands Ranch, and Sweeney tried to make that a different story, but he didn't, and then Sheldon Hafner wrestled it out of Sullivan's hands, and it went out of bounds, so it will be Ranch ball.
And that last shot there from Ranch really kind of showed what I was talking about earlier about how to beat Vista in transition. They got the turnover on that ball and just immediately passed it away to try and get a fast break.
Right. And I think that'll be crucial for both teams, really, because it seems like they're both solid defensively. I don't know. What are your thoughts there? All right. And Highlands Ranch with another three, this time from Sullivan. And so that will put them on top, 5-8. Ranch now leading. Garrett Sweeney over to Ben Willis. Willis drives inside, kicks it out to Sweeney, and Sweeney with the three. So it is a tie game and an energetic one. Now Kurt's driving down the court, surveying his options.
Sweeney and Sullivan both accounting for 5 points for
really?
Vista and Ranch.
There we go. And now, ooh, good play there. Connor Stive drives inside. No good. No foul. And Ranch will pass it all the way over to the other side of the court to Sullivan. Sullivan will kick it over to number 30, Clark.
Stive went for the block and got a fistful of nothing there.
Oh, man. And then, ooh, almost an alley-oop there from teammate. Maybe playing a little bit too much ahead there. But Courage will take a shot. He'll get a good fast break out of that. And now Garrett Sweeney gets an option, or excuse me, an opportunity to fire back. Jack, what do you think about the shooting on both teams here?
Shooting's been a little sloppy, I think, on both sides. I mean,
right as we say,
right as we say that, Connor Stive drains a beautiful three-pointer, but it's been a little sloppy, I think, going back and forth, especially on the inside part.
Right, and considering that the first period's almost over and we are just barely in double-digit scoring, we haven't seen great defensive efforts either. So
yeah, they've left a lot of wide open shots, but there's been a lot of missed shots from both sides.
Right. We'll just call it the warm-up period.
Yeah. Just getting started.
Ranch inside to Sullivan. Ooh, Sullivan will get an option or an opportunity. Man, I keep saying that. To get a third point out of that shot there.
It's a good job by Sullivan driving inside and getting the and one off.
Absolutely. Checking in now from Mountain Vista, we have Ben Grusing, Luke Boying, Simon May, Garrett Sweeney, and number 3, Eric Kimmel. And now Sullivan will get a chance. Will get a chance at a third point out of that shot. And he'll make it. That adds to his stats. And then Boyink will take the ball. Boying passes over to Kimmel.
Sullivan has 8 points right now for Ranch. He's really
putting them in on top now.
Really? 8 out of 13?
Yeah.
What's that, like 70% of their points?
Just about, I would think.
Sweeney looking for some options. Simon May. Over to Grusing. Ben Grusing trying to drive, and they'll call him on a travel. Questionable call.
Yeah, a little bit of questionable of a call, but...
I guess you could say he dragged his foot. I don't know. We can't really see from our angle the best right there. So we'll give him the benefit of the doubt. But now Courage has the ball. And Courage will pass it over to Sullivan. Sullivan to Hammond. Hammond to Mesfin. And let's see. It looks like they're trying to do a lot outside of the key and kind of let Sullivan take an opportunity inside as he takes a shot. From somewhat inside the key. And now Kimmel with the ball. He'll drive inside and kick it out to Sweeney, who thinks about the three-point shot. He'll get around him instead, and he'll jump up and almost makes it, but it does not go in his favor. Scores 11-15, Falcons leading the Eagles.
With that last shot, that was Sullivan's 10th point of the game.
Really?
Yeah, he's already in double digits early on.
Wow. Maybe we'll see a double-double out of him.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, and Ben Grusing with the ball now. He kicks it over to Simon May with a three-point attempt, which will go out of bounds.
Yeah, ball didn't quite take the best bounce. It bounced up too high and hit that rim in there that pulls the net up.
Right. I always hated that when I was a player, yeah. Taking that shot and you're like, yes, I got it. I'll bounce it off the backboard and it'll go in. And instead
and then it
decides.
Just hits right off a rope. Yeah, right. And you're like, oh, thanks.
Yeah. And now we have, Nahom Mesfin with the ball, and he'll pass it back to him. Trying to get some good motion, but turnover there, back-to-back turnovers, actually.
And that's what I was talking about earlier in the game with the trying to force the ball down the field too much. Kimmel got the turnover and immediately just threw it away.
Right. I think that's one of the things that Mountain Vista has struggled with this year is really not so much ball control when they're, like, dribbling it and driving down the court, but more when they're trying to kick it out to their other teammates. And now... Sullivan will get another chance at a three-point attempt from within the key.
Sullivan just stood right down there and took all those shots Vista was taking at him to try and block that ball, and he just laid it right in and then got the and one.
Man, he's having a great night, and there's 13 points for Sullivan.
We got no shot.
Maybe his foot was on the line? Something. The refs are going to deliberate.
Not exactly
deliberate
sure what's
here.
Happening here.
I don't know if they are either. shooting two, I guess.
Shooting. Why would he be shooting two, though? He made the basket, so there's no reason for him to shoot two.
Right. The coaches on the ranch side
yeah,
clearly don't
count.
Like that. Making some interesting hand motions over there. Looking like our producer, Blaze Shower.
Yeah. Gives us hand motions you don't quite understand.
Right.
All right, so looks like he'll take an attempt now, I guess.
I guess so, and the ref goes, my bad.
That was an interesting little sequence there.
Right, and that one will be his 13th point.
I guess it really didn't matter in the end. He made the shot either way.
And Stibe. Now with the ball, he'll kick it over to just outside.
Boing. Air ball there from Boing.
And they'll call it down. Mountain Vista ball. Ben Grusing will pass it in on their side of the court. Well, their offensive side of the court.
Yes. I had to think about that one for a second there.
Right, yeah. I got it. I covered. Yeah,
eventually we'll get there.
Right, and with 33 seconds just about. I would expect Mountain Vista to kind of slow it down and pass around here.
Yeah, they're going to try and take the last shot of the quarter.
Right. That no shot clock really helps in high school. As you can see, Ben Grusing just holding it right now. He'll probably hold it for another 6 or so seconds.
Yeah. I mean, that is my least favorite rule in the high school book, just because I think it just kind of kills the game, especially when it's in the fourth and a team might be up like 4 points with like 40 seconds left.
Absolutely. And Luke Boyne almost makes that shot. 1.8 seconds left. He'll huck it down the court, and that one got really close.
Wow. That was quite an impressive shot there from him. And
absolutely.
Real close.
I've always wanted to see someone make one of those. We've been covering these games for, well, I've been covering them for 2 years now. You've been covering for three. Have you ever seen anyone make a shot like that?
It was not like that, but I remember last year, the famed Judd Erickson, I guess, the guy that tried out for the basketball team as a joke and then turned out to make the team. I remember last year in the first game of the season against Liberty, he was in the first quarter, and they just kind of threw the ball out to him, and he just kind of flicked it up. It wasn't even much of a shot. It was a line drive that somehow went in for a three-pointer right at the end of the half.
It helps when you're a quarterback.
Yeah, I guess so. Get a little more arm strength.
Right. I don't know. If I saw one of those shots, I would feel like Jim Nance when he saw the helmet catch from Antonio Brown.
Yeah, there you go.
And we will now, once Highlands Ranch High School gets back out there, we'll start the second period of the game, the second quarter. Score is 11-18. 8 minutes left in this half.
And 13 of those 18 points are accounted for Sullivan. So, I mean, we expected him to have a monster game, but I didn't think he would have 13 points through the first quarter.
Right, and what does he average per game?
He averages about 21 points a game, so.
So he's well on the way to breaking that average.
He's on the way to hitting 50-plus points a game if he continues.
Wow. All right, well, best of luck to him, but not enough luck to outscore the Eagles here.
Yeah.
And
now Vista looks like they're going to their pressure defense.
Right. A lot more man-to-man.
They're going to put two guys on the ball.
Yeah.
They're going to really flow with the offense.
Right. It appears actually to be more of a zone defense. Akil looks to be a floater. And Ranch will get a three there. Akil will pass in to Yamani. Yamani over to Wallaber. Wallaber out to Simon May. May drives inside, puts up a shot, not the best opportunity for him, so Nesfin will get the ball, and he will pass it down. Ranch takes a way deep three and will drain it. There's 3 points for Hurdle, and now Yamani has the ball once again, and he almost loses track of it. Good recovery there. Akil thinks about the shot. Akil decides otherwise and passes it over to Wallaber, who recovers his own. Back to Akil.
RJ had, I think, about 6 feet of room there from behind the arc, but no way that a big man like him is going to make a shot there.
Right. I'd love to see one of those,
yeah,
too.
And Shaq Ranch. Three ball.
Ooh, Mesfin had a good opportunity there. They're really trying to play outside the perimeter. It looks like Ranch has taken a lot of three opportunities. Perhaps that's the way they're coached. And there's another three for Brendan Sullivan, and timeout from the woods.
Hurdle's got 6 points.
Six
and he's
points?
Played about a minute and a half now in the game.
Man.
So,
do you think that this lead differential is something for Mountain Vista to be worried about, or do you think that this is something that's like healthy with the pacing of this game?
I think with the way that Ranch has scored the last three or four shots that have made it, I think you do need to worry about it a little bit, because the defense is really breaking down and not looking good at all. And really, Vista just doesn't look like they have an answer for Sullivan at all.
Right. I will say, from my own experience, there's usually a shift in the lead right after halftime. So for me, this isn't worse news for Mountain Vista, but I think the Woods made a good call there by taking a timeout. I'd like to see them put some more points on the board.
Definitely. I think the timeout really slowed the game down for them, and hopefully they can kind of recoup and figure things out.
Absolutely. And here is Stieb taking it to the top, seeing what kind of play they can set up. RJ Wallaber with the pick, and he does not take that shot. Wasn't really a good opportunity, so he made a good call there. Simon May drives inside. Interesting hook shot there. No good for him. Now Sullivan with the ball. Sullivan kicks it over to 23 Hurdle. Hurdle over to Courage. Courage inside to 15 Lathrop. And now Courage with the ball again. And that will be
timeout.
Timeout?
No.
No, I believe a charge.
Foul.
On
Ranch. On Hurdle.
Yeah, 23.
I didn't see what the foul was, but.
Right. It. I don't know. I'm not sure. It could have been a push in the back.
Either way, Vista gets the ball now.
Right. And now Connor Steib will take it back at the top of the key with 5 minutes and 45 seconds remaining in the half. Let's see what they can get going. He'll drive inside, and he'll lose track of it and turn it right over to Ranch. Ranch will kick it out to number 44, whose shot is no good. 44 there is Seventhal. And they will call a foul on him. That will be a charge, and so Simon May will pass it back out to Connor Steib.
It was a great job there by Andrew Yamani to just stand his feet solid and take the charge.
Right. They can't call it a block like that when you just stand solid like that. And there's Connor Steib putting some more points on the board for Mountain Vista.
Ends the scoring run there for Ranch.
And the drought for Vista as well. And now Yamani playing some tough defense. And here's Simmental with the ball. Here's their big man, number 15, Lathrop.
Oh!
No good.
Oh, RJ with a huge block there.
There we go. And then Simon May drives. Ooh, kicks it out. Yamani with a three-point attempt. No good. But right under to Akil, who gets similarly redirected. And Courage setting up a play here. Back to Brendan Sullivan. He'll drive inside. He'll take a shot, and that will go in. Almost a dunk there. Simon May with the ball, trying to fast break it. Saw Akil, decided not to. Thought that could result in a turnover. So he'll push it back out to Connor Steib, and they'll try to set something up at the top.
Ooh, poor foul there by Seminole. That one didn't have to happen.
Let's see. I don't know. I don't think the nice thing about this game, well, nice thing for the players and the coaches, not so nice for the crowd, it's a low foul game.
Yes.
So we're not going to approach the bonus in this half. At least if we do, it's going to be impressive.
Yes. With three fouls on each side, it would be very impressive if we do, I think.
Right, because we'd have to foul 5 times on both sides.
Yeah.
And so Ranch
it could happen.
It could. I've seen it. Ooh. Solid rebound by Simon May, and now WWE wrestle that ball to the ground.
Simon May got flipped there by a Seminole.
Right. I believe the refs called that a jump ball, and so Simon May will turn in, or will pass in that
so
ball.
Called a flip ball more than anything.
May to Boyink. Boyink takes the ball. Over to Albertson. Albertson looking inside. Decides to kick it out to Boyink. Boyink probably back to May. May will drive inside there, see what he can get, and 2 points for Simon May.
Three ball looked pretty open there for Simon May. Pulled it down and then decided to drive it inside. Worked out for him.
I always appreciate when the taller guys do that because they have the potential to drive inside, which they're much more structured for, as opposed to Courage with another three-point shot there.
Left them wide open outside the arc.
Right. I think Mountain Vista might want to consider going back to their man defense as some interesting turnovers, like
going
three back
and
back
forth
to
there, yeah.
Yeah. With 3:30 in the clock, in the first half, we have Mountain Vista 15, Highlands Ranch 32 points. So Ranch more than doubling Vista's score in this first half.
Not what you want to see from the Vista side of things.
Right. Boyink struggling to find someone in. Ranch doing really well on defense.
Yeah, they are really shutting down Vista.
Right. And here's Courage trying to get something going. It doesn't take, so he'll pass it over to Yasvet.
Jeez.
And it's underneath lane, right in the middle.
Vista
Simon
is
May.
So sloppy right now. It is not good at all.
Right. This team has not really hit their stride yet.
No, they are really struggling right now to play defense and create shots.
Absolutely.
It's kind of tough to watch right now.
Right. I think if you look at last week's game against Thunder Ridge, you would notice that it was a much more intense game. There was a lot more fouled. Obviously, it was a much bigger rivalry, so there was much more on the line. But there was a lot more running back and forth and a lot more passion involved. right now, a lot of these guys don't look like they're breaking a sweat, which isn't something you really want to see.
Yeah, they just kind of let gas right now, and I mean, we can see Bob Wood very clearly just laying it into him right now, trying to get him fired up for this, because they just look kind of defeated at this point.
Right. Brian Wood motioned over to the Connor Stibe there for a second. Maybe he's subbing in.
Yeah, that's okay. Stibe will come back in.
Sounds good.
I think that's what Vista needs to do, is put their best players in right now.
And it looks like that's what they did.
Ride it out for halftime, until halftime, right. I think. See if they can get anything going.
Yeah, because they have now Simon May, number 3, Eric Kimmel, number 4, Garrett Sweeney, number 12, Reese Pulling, and number 21, Connor Stibe. So Kimmel with the ball. He'll take it to the opposition. And he'll try to find someone, but he's getting stuck up. And
hold.
Interesting.
And that's going to get called for a second foul now.
Right.
So we now are approaching your bonus line there.
Right. We are getting close. We're two away. Maybe we'll get there. Now Connor Stibe with the ball at the top of the key. Don't be surprised if they try to cut inside.
Ooh.
That was definitely a foul. That's a push. One away from the bonus. Yeah, it appears that we actually will reach that point.
Hey, now you jinxed it again there.
And now Simon May is shooting two. Trying to bring the lead within 20?
17.
17. No good there. It was a 1-1 attempt. Oh, excuse me, 7 fouls to get to the bonus. So Mountain Vista does have the bonus now. Now Ranch trying to get with their something going. Oh, and a nasty behind the back. And Garrett Sweeney with 2 points, 17-34.
Smooth play there between Eric Kimmel and Garrett Sweeney.
That was an amazing steal.
Yeah, it was great.
You don't see those
kind of chance and just kind of poked his arm in there and got that one.
Right, and you don't see that kind of ball handling in high school very often, that behind-the-back dribble right after the steal.
Yeah, that was great.
Yeah. And now driving inside is Courage. Courage, ooh, Sullivan, interesting moving pick there.
Yeah, that was – I saw what you were seeing there too, Riffle, and not quite sure about that one.
Right, I don't know. It is a high school game. The officiating isn't always top-notch on both sides of the ball. And let's see, some kind of foul there.
Stibe will go to the line, it looks like.
Ah, approaching that double bonus now. So here's a 1-1 attempt for Stibe. Mountain Vista, the one thing they are doing very well this half is their fouls. They're keeping them in really great check. There's another one for Connor Stibe.
He's got 8 now. He's leading the team in points so far.
They'll need him to do that more. Yes. And some other players to contribute as well.
That one will bring it to 9.
Stibe with a great free throw percentage. That carried over from last year very well.
Yeah, he's sitting right about 81% so far on the year. So.
Really? That's unheard of in high school.
Yes, that is a ridiculous number.
Right.
That's a good number even for NBA.
Yeah, for real. And Sullivan with a nasty dunk. I'll give him that one.
Wow, he really got up there to get that one in.
It helps when you have the lane wide open.
Yes.
But Sweeney answers back with a wide open 3. Oh.
That one will bring Sweeney into the double digits now with 10, but Sullivan's doubling him up here. He's got 20.
Right. And here is Yosfet. He had the ball there over to big boy 15, Lathrop. And they'll drive it inside with Sullivan again, and that will be called as a foul. I believe Reese Pulling showing some good sportsmanship there on both teams. And now he'll take 2 from the line.
Reese Pulling, I think, is one of the really good stories so far this season. I mean, he's a kid that, you know, you kind of look at him in the halls or look at him on the court and you go, well, he doesn't look that athletic or anything.
Right.
But, I mean, man, has he really shown up this year and played really well off the bench for Vista?
Oh, absolutely.
And especially for him not being the biggest guy either. He can really drive against and play hard against a lot of those bigger guys that are on varsity.
Right. And when we say not the biggest guy either, we're talking like Reese is like 6'1", 6'2", 6'3", neighborhood. So he's still a big guy.
Yeah,
he's
got a little bit of height to him. But
right.
He is very skinny.
Yes, that is true. And Garrett Sweeney with a good push inside there. And now with 55 seconds left in this half, we'll see what either team can do with the ball here. Nahom dribbling inside. He'll take a shot. Didn't really have his feet planted there. Eric Kimmel over to Garrett Sweeney. Sweeney on fire right now. Kimmel, they're going to try to slow it down. And Sweeney, three shot.
Ball.
No.
Oh,
wow.
Garrett Sweeney is
with
on
a hot
fire.
Streak.
Gee.
What's he at now,
He's
Jack?
He's at 15.
15?
15 points.
You're kidding.
Yeah.
So Garrett Sweeney, so what we scored. Okay, wow.
Almost half, yes.
Almost half. That's incredible. Way to go, Garrett Sweeney. Get this man a scholarship.
That's the stuff you really want to see from Garrett Sweeney.
Absolutely.
He's one of your best shooters.
Right. Oh, not fooled by it on the ranch side of the ball. And they'll pop up a shot now.
Oh.
And an impressive three buzzer beater from Hammond.
At the end of that half, Vista trails 27-41, and that is not the half that you wanted to see there from Mountain Vista.
Not ideally, no. And additionally, I'd like to talk about some of the stats now here. I'm seeing that we have two players in double digits on both sides of the ball. I believe both of them well above their average points per game.
Sullivan's right about his average right now. He's got 20. But Garrett Sweeney is above his average. He averages about 12, and he's about 3 above now. So Sweeney's definitely playing well today. So, I mean, I think that's really good to see from him.
Right. It seems like Sweeney has really hit his stride. It'll be interesting to see how he does coming out of halftime, if he's able to maintain his heart rate and all of that going into the locker room.
But, for halftime, we will have a performance from the Mountain Vista Palms and Junior Palms, I believe.
It used to really bother me. Now I just laugh because I know the truth. I know how hard those girls work.
Feeling really good. We've like really bonded as a team and we've come far since we first started.
I'm really proud of my This season, and it's paid off, and we've done really well.
I feel really good about the season. We didn't have the greatest placement outcome, but as a team and as a captain, I'm really proud of the dances we put out.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1,
Palms is kind of dual-sided in that like the school sees one side at football games and assemblies, and then the other side is more competitive and more intense, where it's technique and more like competition.
The work ethic of a dancer is pretty amazing. For example, my varsity Palm girls train with me 4 days a week. In addition, they are taking 20 to 30 hours a week of outside dance classes. So they're practicing with me, they're dancing at their studio, they're performing at games, they're competing. So it's safe to say that dancers spend 20 to 30 hours a week, year-round, dancing. So we've been very fortunate that we have a very successful program, and I think that's because we train hard every day. You can't just show up at state and win. You can't show up at nationals and win. You start training the day you make the team. So we train hard all day, all year long, and make sure that we are constantly training as champions.
Yeah, I want to dance in college, but I'm not sure where yet.
I do want to dance in college, and I still haven't decided.
Pretty amazing that a lot of the dancers that I have been able to go on and dance at the college level. I've got dancers at CU right now, which is the main school that my dancers will feed into. I've had dancers attend BYU, CSU, and it's great to watch them do that. And then I've had dancers go on and become professional cheerleaders. So it's pretty amazing. Also, a lot of my dancers are now back coaching at the high school level. So it's really fun for me to see them come back and give part to the program that raised them.
It takes a lot of extra work on the sides, and it takes to be able to work with all of your team members and be able to help everybody.
All right. Just being really friendly to everyone, helping them out when it's needed, and like figuring out little stuff.
I think a lot of it is just selflessness, kind of, like putting the team before yourself and then just being a role model for everyone else.
The greatest joy in my life is not so much the competitions or the practice time, it's the time where I'm just getting to spend with the girls. Most of them hang out in my office at lunch, and we just get to visit, and I get to watch them grow into strong, capable young women, and that is the ultimate reward for me.
Welcome back from halftime. I'm Jake Riffle, joined here by Jack Schauer. Jack, I want to ask you kind of what you think about these teams from this last half. I want to talk about what Mountain Vista needs to do to improve on the game. and maybe what they need to continue doing to win this game.
I think for Vista, I think they got to find their defense. They've looked really, really poor on the defensive side, leaving shots wide open and just kind of making it a little bit too easy for Ranch. Offensively, I think they need to pass the ball a little more. They're trying to force it inside a little bit too much, and I think they need to pass the ball around a little bit more before trying to make a shot.
Right, and I think they need to be careful with their passes as well. We've seen a lot of unnecessary turnovers just from passing. And Connor Stibe now with the ball over to Eric Kimmel. Kimmel over to Sweeney. Sweeney will drive inside. He's been on fire. And that will be called a foul.
They will count the shot, too.
Garrett Sweeney with another three-point attempt here. Just not really the way he thought.
Yeah. Used to seeing him make three-pointers from outside the arc, not inside, usually.
Right. And there's another point for Sweeney's name. And now Ranch will get the ball. 30-41, 7:51 in the third.
Sweeney has 18 now for Vista.
18? Sweeney accounts for a good chunk of those points, huh?
More than almost two-thirds of the points for Vista.
Right. Well, here's Brendan Sullivan passing it over to number 11, Hammond. Hammond back into Courage. Courage kicks it out to 23 and just a little bit short there. Garrett Sweeney with the ball now. He will pass it over to Simon May. Simon May drives inside and... Ooh.
Oh.
Really?
It looked like it went off of...
24.
Johnson's shoe.
Right.
I thought it went off his foot, but I guess not, so...
I don't know. There have been calls that both teams have gotten away with right off the bat here.
It's going both ways. You can't really argue if it's going both ways.
Right. So I'll take it. Whatever. And now here is Brendan Sullivan back over to Courage. Courage takes a shot. Jumper. Ooh, air ball. And... There's the chant.
There it is.
And now, oh, thought he had a nice, easy under the hoop layup there. But they'll kick it over to Aaron Albertson with the three ball, just a little too much there. And number 23, Hurdle, will recover it. Here is number one, Courage, at the logo. Trying to get something going there. Mountain Vista playing tougher on defense, a little closer, but they might need to consider playing a little tighter in there. Ooh!
Oh.
And a nasty rebound from Aaron Albertson. And Connor Stibe inside. Oh!
And that's one we're used to making seeing Connor. Wow. That's one we're used to seeing Connor make.
Right. That's usually his time to shine right there. Oh! That'll count is inside.
Oh! Connor Stibe going up for the dunk.
Speak of the devil.
Wow!
All right. Man. Man, now here's that energy that we needed
that is,
from Mountain Vista.
That is the way you want to see Vista come out.
Right, 32-41, already cutting it to 9 points from, what was it, like 17, 18 points? That's good. That's cut in half right there.
Man, when Stavka stole that ball, I kind of had a feeling he was going to go up like that.
Right. Get that man a scholarship. Yeah. All right, 25. Brendan Sullivan, a couple more, or one more point to his name. We'll see if he'll add another one here. Sullivan's second free throw is good there. Simon May almost swinged it out to Sweeney. Swung it out to Sweeney. Sweeney looking for it. Simon May holding on to it. Connor Stibe will take the three shot. Oh, almost goes in. And Highlands Ranch with the ball now. That will be number 23, Hurdle. He'll drive inside. He'll get a good run out of it. And that ball barely bounces out. And
goes off Stibe's head, it looked like.
Right. No kick, no head, no worries. Now, Sullivan. Ranch with the ball. Sullivan pushes it inside. And that was a good play, but nothing came up out of it.
Sullivan
and now
was
Eric
trying
Kimmel.
To draw a foul there.
Right, and Simon May, ooh.
I don't think Simon May should have taken that shot, but in the end it works out, and he will get a couple free throws for it.
Right, I believe he's been perfect from the line tonight, too. And if not, he's missed one or two.
He's been 2 for 2 from the line.
Two for
so
two.
Far.
All right, well, that is a perfect score.
Both of his points are free throws.
Right. And here he goes again. 3 for 3. Can he make it 4 for 4? With some substitutions, Reese pulling in for Aaron Albertson and bringing in number 11, Hammond, for number 1, Courage. Simon May, 4 for 4. He's 100% tonight.
He's looking good from the line.
Absolutely. And now number 30, Clark, with the ball. He'll pass it over to their big man, 15, Lathrop. And they'll try and push it inside. But they'll float around the perimeter until they get an open lane. That's something Mountain Vista's been playing well with, is making sure they don't get that open lane and really trying to push there.
Yeah, they've Simon really limited the...
you're fine.
Trying to figure out what happened. They really have limited Ranch on the inside scoring game, but Ranch has kind of counteracted that by just nailing a bunch of three-pointers.
Right, and interestingly, Mountain Vista played a lot of zone defense the first half, which we will hardly ever see out of them. They're sticking to their guns with man-to-man this half. I think was a wise decision, honestly, because they seem like they've got a lot more juice in the tank, and they're starting to hit that perfect moment of tired but not exhausted. And Mountain Vista will get the inbound the ball here on their own offensive sideline. Checking in is number 3, Nahom Mesfin, as well as number 15, Lathrop. Oh, almost shot that one.
Pulling will get some free throws for that one. It was a good play.
Absolutely. There we go. Reese Pulling doing well for, what is he, a sophomore?
Sophomore. He's the only underclassman on the team. Everyone else is juniors or seniors.
Absolutely. What a guy, man. And he'll add another point. Well, I guess his first point.
His first point.
And that one not as good. Branch with the ball. Over to Lathrop. Lathrop back over to Hammond. Hammond will get it past the logo. And back to Nahom. And then trying to drive inside, but finding more pressure from Mountain Vista this time around. Vista will try and keep him outside the three-point line, even though they've excelled there as well. Ooh,
Sweeney almost got the steal there.
Right. Oh, and a football pass down to Simon May. He waits opportunely, and no foul call there. A little questionable, but it's high school.
Yeah.
And, ooh.
That's been no good.
Nahom, no good. Trying to get a lot of underneath pressure, and there's that foul.
Oh, called the foul, yeah, on the other side of the court, but...
Well, 35-45, Mountain Vista is trailing 10 points with 3 minutes and 33 seconds in the third period.
Hammond coming to the line. He's got 8 tonight for Ranch.
Can he get to double digits?
Sinks both of these, he will.
As of now, no.
Not this time.
Not this time.
So Mental subs in for Ranch.
Seeing a bit of a drought here from really both of the teams. There's not many points going. Both of them have been free throws so far, I believe.
Yeah, Vista came out of the half swinging and put up a solid 9 points, and then Ranch had their own in 4. But really since then, since the first 2-3 minutes of this court or this half, hasn't really been much.
Right. The trick will be really who's more on top of it, not who has better ball handling or shooting or anything like that, just who is more in the game when it comes down to the fourth period in 3 minutes and 20 seconds. And Stibe with the just a little bit short 3-pointer. And it's recovered by Brendan Sullivan. And him and Reese pulling, squaring off. Reese keeping good coverage there. Oh!
Faked him out. Stive was looking for a penalty, and Sweeney turns this one over.
And Nahom will drive inside, and they'll get that one as well. 35-50, Falcons leading. Got to watch for the wolf play here. Ooh, Ben Grusing with a good stop. And Grusing over, or excuse me, May over to Grusing. Grusing will push outside. They're trying to get four guys out on the perimeter there, it looks like. But that leaves no one to get the board. So Nahom will drive down. And Nahom, questionable double dribble there. Coach even said it there. let's see. Number 15, Lathrop, loses it for a minute, but it's picked up by Nahom. Nahom Mesfin will drive inside. Ooh. And get it in their hands of Brendan Sullivan. And Sullivan will kick it over to Hammond. Obviously, they're taking advantage of that shot clock moment here. They're really trying to keep that deficit alive. So Ben Grusing obviously going to try and cut inside, get something going, whatever works for Mountain Vista to cut that deficit. And they'll drive in, and Reese pulling with a rejected three. And some kind of foul. Number 12, Reese Pulling.
It will be on Pulling. Pulling will come off the court, as well as Stibe and Hefner and Boyink will come in. We're going to go full court press now for Vista. I think that's a good call. Try and change up the defense a little bit, I think.
Absolutely. Try and keep that a much more high-pressure mentality. But they really need to make sure they're covering guys. They can't leave anyone open, because they've all proven, even though that Sullivan's their best player, they've proven they can shoot from outside behind the arc. So they really got to keep pressure on these guys. They're doing that well right now.
Oh. Sullivan draws a foul. Great play there by Brendan Sullivan. He's been their guy tonight. He's got 24 points.
Really? 24. So he accounts for
almost half.
About a third? Yeah. Or more like 40%. But
close enough.
Yeah. We're good. And here he is trying to add to that. He'll get that one. And Mountain Vista trying to push it fast, trying to get some stuff outside, cut back inside. Maybe push it back out again, or Simon May will take that questionable shot.
May needs to stop taking those four shots. He's really turning the ball over too much and not making enough.
Right, and ooh, almost a thing there. 45 seconds left in the third period. Garrett Sweeney with the ball. Sweeney kicks it out to Simon May. He'll take a three-point attempt, and he'll drain it, ending his personal drought as well as Mountain Vista's. And 34 seconds left.
Ranchers, I think, is going to try and drain some clock here.
I would agree. They're going to try and just hold on to that lead deficit. Jack, what do you think these two teams need to do in this last quarter in order to, you know, continue either what they've been doing or really improve on what they need to?
I think Ranchers needs to keep doing what they're doing, really not allowing any shots inside from Vista.
Right.
Oh, really goes in there. I think they need to keep doing what they're doing, though, not allowing any shots inside from Vista, forcing them outside. And for Vista, they got to get something going. I think they need to maybe put the bench in a little bit more, switch things up, because right now you have Garrett Sweeney and Connor Stibe accounting for 27 of your points, and then Simon May with another 7, and the rest is kind of scattered around. So, I mean, really, I think you got to get other guys involved right now. I think you're relying too much on Stibe and Sweeney.
I agree. I think we'll see a lot, though, in this quarter of Simon May, Reese Pulling, Aaron Albertson. Let's see. Honestly, it's the fourth quarter. They're probably, with that kind of lead deficit, they're probably going to keep Sweeney and Stibe in.
I think you got to use Sweeney for the three ball more so.
Right.
And then I think you turn to Stibe to try and drive it inside. I mean, we really haven't seen too much of, Ryan Tubbs called the other commentator. It's kind of his magic when he really drives it inside, kind of does some flashy things, and then lays it in. You just kind of sit there and you go, well, how'd that happen? I mean, we haven't really had too many of those moments so far today.
Yeah, there's been two that I can think of, which is not enough for this score. So we need to see more out of them. And then we also, I think personally, we need to see more out of Sheldon Hafner. We need to see him in the game more. I understand his shoulder's dislocated, but the coach is like, if he's good to go, he needs to play.
Agreed.
And there he is, speak of the devil. Ooh, good board there from Ben Grusing. And Grusing kicks it over to Boink, who almost gets that three ball.
Boink hasn't made a shot so far in this game. It's not what we're used to seeing from him.
Really? Maybe try starting with twos then instead. And then Mountain Vista. That'll be called a
Yamani.
Push. Yeah. 5-3 as far as fouls go. Now 6-3. Mountain Vista leading there. Kind of the opposite story of the last one.
Vista really needs to try and flip that around.
Right. Ben Willis now in. And Yamani. They got a lot of their good defensive players right now.
Looked like the ranch coach was looking for an explanation there, and the ref, I think, gave him that Sullivan dragged a little.
Sounds about right. And then Connor Stibe will try and pull some of that magic.
And that's what we needed to see from Stibe. He didn't make the shot, but he will take some free throws.
There we go.
This is the guy you want at the line for Vista.
Right. And it's interesting, I think, with the substitutions. It looks like they've got a clear defensive-offensive substitution going with a lot of hang time. Or not a lot of hang time, excuse me. Stibe will make one. High five it up.
You always got to give a few high fives after making one.
Stibe will make two. 13 points for Stibe.
This is still down 15.
Ranch really going to try to hold on to that ball. Mountain Vista, if they...
Over the back.
And that will give Ranch the bonus. So 1-1 shooting. Number 30, Clark. Clark makes his first.
His first point of the game.
Clark will also drain his second one. And Ben Willis, no good on that shot. Try to put some tough full-court press on him.
Poor shooting from Mountain Vista.
And looks like a push. Number 11, actually, Andrew Yamani.
Yamani wasn't even near the play there, but...
I don't know.
Interesting call, I guess.
I think Mountain Vista has kind of self-destructed a little bit this game.
Yeah, they really have put themselves into this hole. I mean, they've played, you know, you look at the Thunder Ridge game, and I mean, they played the second half of that game very poorly, but I think this doesn't even compare to that. Like, this has just been absolutely awful for Mountain Vista. I mean, not so much offensively, but...
Ooh, gee! There's some of that.
There's the flashy Connor Stibe that we've been looking for. But finishing that thought, not so much offensively has been a problem for Vista, but defensively, I mean, they've just been horrendous.
Right. I don't know. There will be another foul for them. Pushing it to 9 fouls. Getting really close to the double bonus here.
almost a 20-point lead for Ranch.
Sullivan might secure that 20-point lead for them here.
19-point lead.
Oh, excuse me. Garrett Sweeney trying to do what he can about that. He'll give it over to Stibes. Stibes will drive inside, work his magic, but foul on 30, who says, no, hands were up, ref. But Stibes will get two more.
In the last 2 minutes from Connor Stibes have been really what we're used to seeing from him, and I think you just wish you would have seen this a little more throughout the first part of this game.
Right. We needed it earlier. He'll miss his first one. He's thinking the same thing. He's in his head. He needs to give himself a break there. He's looking nervous, and Mountain Vista needs to really take a breath if they want to have a shot in these last 6 minutes and 12 seconds. There he goes.
Makes the second.
43-61, 6:12 left. Highlands Ranch coach upset about plays.
They gave Bob Wood a warning, actually. He's giving the ref an earful.
All right, well, Highlands Ranch trying to kick something off here. Expect to see a lot of full court press from Mountain Vista and expect to see a lot of swinging the ball around from Highlands Ranch. Unless, of course, it's something like that.
It'll be Ranch ball.
Ranch ball?
I guess it'll be Ranch ball down in the...
All right, could have been tipped. 6:06 left. 43-61, Falcons leading. And they'll push it over to number 24, Johnson. He'll kick it out to Sullivan. Over to 30. 30 inside to 24. Johnson. Johnson, no good on the shot. RJ with the rebound. Over to Sheldon Hafner. Hafner trying to push it back inside, get more motion on the court. Sweeney thinks about it, trying to fake him out. Ooh, and an excellent pass over to Yamani, who does not make the three. And
Sullivan.
Ranch.
Great balance there, stay in bounds.
Absolutely. And he will pass it over to 11, Hammond.
Hammond almost lost his footing there trying to cut back.
Right. Now you're hearing ISO from, I believe, the coach.
So Yamani fouls now.
Brian Wood talking to him. Now it puts them in double bonus territory.
Clark 3-for-3 free throw shooting so far tonight. Four for four shooting tonight.
20-point lead for Ranch with 5:14 left.
Not the best showing from Mountain Vista.
No. Do they still have potential? Yes, especially if Sweeney made that shot, and he did.
Wow. Downtown shot there from Garrett Sweeney.
Do that again and again and again.
About 5 or 6 more times, please.
That should get us close to covering it. And you guys got to stop Ranch, too. Come on. The shot. They'll drive inside, kick it out. And 4:40 left. Outside, back outside. They're really going to try to work that outside. Forget about driving inside to take a shot.
They're going to try and kill the clock as much as possible.
Right. Hold.
Foul.
Let's see. Number 4, Garrett Sweeney with the foul. Sweeney now at 21 points, doing great on his point average. It's a good night for his stats, at least.
Very good night for him and Connor Stibes. Just not a great night for Mountain Vista so much.
Right.
The rest of the team has 9 points combined.
And Hammond with his second free throw attempt here. ...47-64. R.J. Wallaber, Connor Stibe. Stibe drives inside, puts it up, and he'll get a foul. So he'll get to shoot two, and as well as pushing up theirs to the bonus. Well, just about the bonus. Stibe makes his first. Missing only one for the night. And there's a second one.
Stibes up to 18 now.
So what you're telling me is that Connor Stibe and Garrett Sweeney have put in like
almost,
90%
almost,
of
almost
the points.
Almost 40 points. They're at 39.
If Mountain Vista wants to win this game, what are they going to have to do, Jack?
Make a lot of baskets and not that much time.
That's a good answer. How are they going to stop them defensively? I mean, like, we've seen them just swinging around the three-point line so many times. Wow!
Oh.
That was a crazy windmill there from number 21, Connor Stibe.
Kind of been our go-to name in the fourth quarter is the Connor Stibe for Vista.
Right. Ooh.
And
there it is again.
There's Connor Stibe again, and he'll draw a foul.
And I believe that puts them at bonus territory.
So
Stibe taking a 1-1 here.
I think it's a little bit too bit, though.
3:45 is possible. It's possible. I'm not going to rule him out.
It's not over till it's over, but Vista really has to go on a big scoring run here.
Or Ranch needs to play really sloppy.
Like, really sloppy.
So here's Connor Stibe. First one good.
Brings him to 21. Him and Sweeney are even now for most points.
Can he make it second? Yes, he does. 52-65. Falcons leading. R.J. Wallaber putting on some pressure there. Full court press. Down outside, a way big lob. And
Hurdle had to get up there to catch that pass.
Right. Number 11, Hammond, trying to get what he can. Just a lot of back in and out. And that shot, no good. Recovered by Garrett Sweeney. 3-6. 3:14 left. Connor Stibe, three ball. No good. Get that bound. Trapped in the corners, R.J. Wallaber. And out on
Ranch. This will get the ball. Wow.
Maybe they're compensating for earlier? I don't know.
I'm not quite sure, but it'll have a timeout by Highlands Ranch. So this is trying to make it a close game, and I mean, they've narrowed the lead a little bit, but
right, 13 points in 3 minutes.
Not undoable, but it's difficult, and you have to also play defense at the same time. So really, it's more than just 3 minutes.
Right. If they don't allow Ranch a shot in any of these 3 minutes, like if Ranch doesn't score, they need to score a little more than 4 points a minute, about 5 points a minute, for them to be safe. And that's including not letting Ranch score. So that would be a three ball and a two ball every 60 seconds.
It's not impossible, but it's doable for sure.
Oh, definitely. Especially if Ranch decides to shoot themselves in the foot here. However, likely, no.
With the way Ranch has played in this game throughout, I think it's going to be very difficult.
Right. Now Mountain Vista will inbound it underneath the hoop they're trying to get the ball into. They'll pass it over to finding someone. Connor Stibe. Stibe takes a three ball.
Deep three ball. Wow.
All right. Maybe they have a shot.
So Garrett Sweeney and Connor Stibe decide they like the deep three-pointer.
If it works, it works. Yeah. They got to go foul, though.
You don't want to foul Sullivan, though. He's too good of a free throw shooter, I think.
Good point.
And that one actually brings Sullivan to 30 tonight.
Andrew Yamani, deep downtown three-point shot.
That's his first point of the game. And it wasn't the three-pointer from Connor Stive or Garrett Sweeney.
Wow. 2:32 left. 10-point
Nine-point. Yes. Wow. So they put 6 points together real quick there.
If they keep playing like that. So timeout called, I believe, Highlands Ranch. It's good for Mountain Vista.
Timeout either way, I think. It's good for Ranch. I think it's good for Vista. Ranch helps them figure out what they need to do defensively. Vista, I think it allows them to sub. They subbed in Sheldon Half there for RJ. So I think it was a good timeout, though.
What do you think of Akil Aries being out on the court right now?
I mean, we haven't really seen too much of him at all this year, but, I mean, he's been playing pretty sharp defense. He doesn't have a point or anything to his name so far, but he's been playing sharp defense so far.
But that's what we need right now.
Yes, they need.
We want to keep them scoreless.
Defense.
Yeah. There we go, like running along. What? I have never seen that ever.
Yeah,
I didn't know that was possible.
I didn't know that you could do that. It would be a foul. And that's more of the guy that you want to foul.
Right.
Vista.
I'll take a foul on Lathrop. Lathrop.
Lathrop.
Struggle with that name.
Yeah, it's a weird one. You're fine.
With 2:28, it'll stay at 9 points for the time being.
Ben Willis subbing in for Sheldon Hafner.
Giving that shoulder a break.
It's also senior night, so you got to give.
Right.
All your seniors a solid chance.
That could be another factor for Akil. And then Garrett Sweeney pushing in. Ben Willis, three.
Knocks
and another one.
Into the
wow.
Game and knocks the three-pointer down.
How about that? 2:19.
Seven-point game. Wow.
So in less than a minute, we've scored 9 points. So I guess our 5 points
kind of
is working
right
out.
I mean,
61-68.
Vista is
trailing
playing
by seven.
Hot right now.
If Mountain Vista can keep this up, they'll win this game. And there's Brian Shockley over there waving the faces, trying to get the crowd hyped up. And there's that Simon May face taunting the Highlands Ranch crowd.
Yeah, I think crowd needs to get into this one. That'll help them out a little
Absolutely.
Bit.
Absolutely. If the crowd can really pump them up.
And we're on the parent side of the stadium, you would call it, of the gymnasium. but the parents were really trying to encourage the players here. It looks like he's limping around a little bit, but I think that's too much of a problem.
He has played two games on his ankle, so I believe they'll keep him in. I bet they'll rest him up if they secure that first
Definitely.
Round bye. The other reason we could have seen not as much of a push from Mountain Vista is because they know they're making it to the playoffs.
Right.
And probably having a first-round bye.
And this game really doesn't affect them too much. If they lose, they'll drop one spot, but they'll still have the bye. If they win, they'll move up one spot, and they'll still have a bye. Really, it's just going to depend on what side of the bracket they get.
Right. So this one could
Mary
more
ball.
Be for pride. Oh! Garrett Sweeney with a great turnover or takeover there, I guess. Connor Stibe, give it over to Hafner. Or drive inside and put
it
in for two.
Great job, Connor Stibe. He's got 27.
Okay, now at 2:03, Mountain Vista has scored 12 points, and Mountain Vista really needs to keep this hard pressure on them. And foul. Good call on Courage, who only has 5 points for the game. I don't know. Has he made any free throws, Jack?
I believe he's made one or two so far tonight. Man. We might have seen him at the line.
You know what? I'll take it, though. 63-68.
2 minutes left. There's plenty of time for this game to flip.
What did I tell you, Jack?
I
mean, don't count them out.
With
don't
6 minutes left,
out.
I thought this one was all wrapped up, but Vistas decide to stay in it.
Oh, no. You need to watch some March Madness,
yeah.
Dude.
learn my lesson, I guess.
All right. 7-point ball game here. Timeout.
Huge free throws there from Courage. A timeout for Ranch.
Minute 58, 7 points. Let's say Highlands Ranch goes down and scores 4 2-point shots
sure.
for the rest of the game.
Sure.
That would give them 74 points, right? Well, to beat that, Mountain Vista would have to have 75. So that would mean that Mountain Vista needs to score 12 more points. In just, we'll call it the 2 minutes remaining, that's six points. So they need to make two 3-point shots a minute, which they've shown they can do.
It's very plausible for Vista to win this game. They got to keep doing what they're doing, I think, and really play that pressure defense. It's been doing its wonders for Vista.
Right. We'll have to see what they can do. They really need to hustle here, though. They can't hold down onto the ball down there.
Aaron Albertson in the game now for Vista.
Get it over to Yamani. Oh, hold on to that ball. And a great foul there from Garrett Sweeney.
And they will intentionally foul Garrett Sweeney.
Highlands Ranch coach very energetic about that one.
Yep. Sweeney's trying to plead his case. That was a little bit more than an oopsie from Ben Willis. That's a big uh-oh, and that one is really going to hurt Vista in the end, I think.
Right. I bet he'll be hearing about that one over the weekend on Tuesday.
Yeah. Sullivan knocks it down. He's at 31.
Oh!
Something I'm not used to seeing. Sullivan missed one.
Right. 8-point game. And Mountain Vista will be defending now.
Sub out Garrett Sweeney for Sheldon Hafner.
I think Hafner's earned a shot here, especially on defense.
Oh!
Get that ball!
Mountain Vista gets the turnover. They got to do something with it, though.
Pass that out. Just someone help him out. Get that ball! Get that ball! Sorry.
Foul.
And pop that.
3-pointer, Yamani. Oh, so good.
All right. Well, we'll see here. Brendan Sullivan drives inside, and don't be surprised. You gotta foul him. We're getting over and back like that. There we go.
8 points.
I'm trying to contain myself right now.
I can tell. Garrett Sweeney comes back in the game now for Vista.
And so does Akil Aries.
I think that's a good move. Put Akil back in. He's been playing well defensively.
Right. Ben Willis to Connor Stibe. Connor Stibe driving.
Doesn't
gets across the three-point line. Yamani got a big body on him.
Yeah.
Connor Stibe, or excuse me, Sweeney with
Sweeney
deep
three. Ball.
No good. No board either. And no pressure on Brendan Sullivan there.
We got a foul.
50 seconds remaining. 63-71. There's a foul.
There it is. I think it might just be a little too late now for Vista. There's only 46 seconds left on the clock.
This time I'm going to agree with you.
Yeah. And it's just unfortunate, I think. I mean, and really disappointing.
Right.
That they only decided to come out here in the fourth. Arthur misses that shot.
You know, it is a good, I guess, precursor for playoffs, you know?
I think it's a good thing almost to have this loss to in a big game like this, kind of, you know, give them a little bit of a wake-up call that, hey, things aren't going to be easy.
Right.
Stibe
and
gets a foul.
Yeah, it's almost like a experiment to see, you know, at what point do we really have to push it? Like, at what point is it too far gone? I think our answer, you got to push it in the second half.
I think they needed to get the bench a little bit more involved than they did today. They relied too heavily, I think, on Connor Stibe and Garrett Sweeney.
Right.
I mean,
Because what, they were the only guys with double-digit points?
Yeah, they're the only guys with double-digit points. The next guy's Simon Nave, but I think you can't really look at Simon because I think he just missed too many shots in this game.
Right. He was only in for, five minutes?
He was in a majority of the game. But I think he just took too many shots that didn't go in. So, I mean, that hurts them, you know.
Right, they had to pull him.
Right. I mean, it also hurts that Ben Grusing has had 0 points, which is a guy that you usually see
right.
with at least five.
Right. Fallon Reese.
Sheldon Hafner's going to try and take a charge.
Will they give it to him?
And...
Worth a shot. I mean, what do you have to lose? You're at double bonus. There's 36 seconds in the game. Worst thing you can do at this point is foul out, and that lasts 36 seconds.
Yeah, and then you just go into next week.
Exactly. Courage will miss that one.
Keeps it a three possession game. Ben Willis, Keel Ayers, and Garrett Sweeney come on the court for Vista. No good there.
Connor
Stibe,
just put something up, man. Take a shot. Don't even try to drive.
Oh.
Just shoot that. Yeah, like that. Ooh. Oh.
That one looked like it was going to go in. Hey, Vista was running down the court, and Yamani was like, hey, guys, you got to play some. You got to get on him here.
You got to play some defense. I know there's 18.9 seconds left, but we got to try something here. And Brendan Sullivan trying to get to 33 points here.
That's just a ridiculous number. Viz is going to go back and look at the game film from this and see that it was just a absolutely terrible outing defensively, especially against Sullivan, and they were really looking to shut him down, and they haven't done that at all in this game.
Right.
Another missed shot. Sullivan. That one will drop, though. 32.
Oh, well, that's one way to end.
Yep. And they'll just let the clock run out now.
Will anyone throw the ball at Jack Lindauer this week?
Well, that's a disappointing ending. Vista really gave him a tough try there in the fourth, but it was just too little too late, I think. And
right.
I think you pack it up, you learn from this game, and you move on to playoffs.
Right, because this is, what, their last game of the season, correct?
Last
the regular?
Of the regular season. So
yeah.
Playoffs start, next game is playoffs. So hopefully they'll get, because the top three teams are right now are Chaparral, Canyon, and Thunder Ridge. Thunder Ridge and Canyon playing tonight, so that'll determine one and two seed, but Chaparral's basically locked in the third. And really, if you're Vista, you want whoever that fourth seed is. That's the side of the bracket you want right now. So, you know, hopefully they'll luck out and get that side, you know, make a little bit of a push. But, I mean, right now they got to improve overall.
Right. I think there will be a lot of lessons learned from this game. I think that Mountain Vista will take some time to rest a lot of their players before the playoffs.
Take the weekend off.
Right. They need to have some healthy players. They need to have Sheldon Hafner healthy, like 100%. They need to have Connor Stibe at 100%. They need to just really keep a lot of their players well-rested physically, not necessarily, like, emotionally. They need to keep them there, at least in the film room, going over plays, stuff like that. But honestly, not the worst thing for Mountain Vista here.
No, I think you need to not dwell on this loss.
Right.
It's not the worst thing.
No, it doesn't really affect him, honestly. But with that, thank you so much for joining us tonight. I have been Jake Riffle.
Yeah. On your one broadcast so far this season?
No, I did too.
No,
I did
one,
Thunder Ridge.
All right.
And I was joined here by Jack Schauer. Thank you so much for joining us, and we will talk to you guys later.